Welcome students, and I am Ravi Shankar. And in this video, we are going to study about the self-inductance of a long solenoid, or we can say it out as an ideal solenoid. If the length of the solenoid is large compared to its radius or compared to its diameter, then if the length is large, then we are saying that solenoid is a long solenoid or an ideal solenoid. So here we are going to consider a long solenoid, and the area of cross section of that solenoid is taken as A. Similarly, the number of turns available in that solenoid for 1 meter length is taken to be small n. And also the current that is passing through the solenoid, I am taking it as I. So a small description regarding this. So I am considering a long solenoid. So I am taking this long solenoid, and the length of this long solenoid, I am taking it as what? I am taking it as L. Similarly, the area of cross section, we are taking it as A. And through this solenoid, the current that is supplied is taken as I. And the number of turns per unit length, for 1 meter length, the number of turns available is taken as small n. If that is the case, let us write a small description for this. So let us consider like this. You consider a long solenoid. Consider a long solenoid, and the long solenoid of length taken to be L. Long solenoid of length L, having area of cross section, having the area of what? Area of cross section as A. A having the area of cross section at as A. Let small n be the number of turns. Let small n be the number of turns available per unit length. For 1 meter length, the number of turns available, let us consider it as what? Let us consider it as small n. Through this solenoid, the current that we have supplied is taken to be I. So I am taking, let I be the amount of current, or I be the current passing through the solenoid. Okay, passing through the long solenoid. Passing through the long solenoid. So let us take this as a small introduction. If you are supplying an electrical current through that coil of wire, then a magnetic field is being developed at any point along the axis of that coil or along the axis of that solenoid. And the value is given by B is equal to mu zero into N into I. Already you might have studied in your third lesson. So I am calculating, therefore, when I am supplying the current, the magnetic field, okay, the magnetic field produced or developed at any point, along the axis of the coil, along the axis of the solenoid, is taken to be, or is given by, B is equal to mu zero into N into I. As you know, mu zero is the permeability of that medium, N number of turns per unit length, and I current passing through it. Since B is the magnetic field, what is the magnetic flux linked with that coil? As we know, the magnetic flux is the dot product of magnetic field and area. Since it is acting along the axis, theta becomes zero, and so we are saying that the flux linked is equal to B into A. So therefore, we can say the magnetic flux linked with each turn, of the coil is, each turn of the coil is given by, what is that flux? In general, flux is given by the formula phi, or we can say it out as phi m, which is equal to magnetic field B dot product multiplied with the area. What is that magnetic field? From the above equation, you can write it out as mu 0 into n into I into A. So the magnetic flux that is linked with each turn of the coil is represented as phi, which is equal to B into A into, or B into A, which is mu 0 into n into I into A. See, but when you are considering this long wire, long solenoid, that long solenoid is having n number of turns for the given length. So what is the total flux linked with all the n number of turns? So let us calculate the total magnetic flux. The total magnetic flux linked with the solenoid, or linked with the n turns of the solenoid. Linked with n turns of the solenoid. Solenoid is given by S. How I can write the total flux? I am writing it as phi B, which is equal to capital N into the flux that is linked with the single turn. So I can write capital N into mu 0 into small n into I into A. Let us take this as equation number 3. What is this capital N? See, where we can write like this, where this capital N is total number of turns, total number of turns in the given length, or in the length of the solenoid L, which is equal to number of turns per unit length multiplied it with L. That is, capital N is equal to small n into L. Take this value and substitute in equation 3. Therefore, I can write phi B is equal to mu 0 into n into I into A. Instead of capital L, I am substituting as n into L. You multiply, you will be getting phi B is equal to mu 0 into n into N. I can write it out as n square into the current I that I have supplied. So mu 0 into n square into I into A into L. So this value, we are taking it as equation number 4. So we have calculated the total magnetic flux that has been linked with the n number of turns in that coil of length L. Now, already we have studied that. Okay, already we have defined that. So we can write, we know that the total magnetic flux available in the coil of wire is given by the formula phi B is equal to L into I. If it is for all the n turns, then I can write n into phi B is equal to L into I. Take this as equation number 5. Now you equate equation 4 as well as equation 5. So I can say equating equations 4 as well as equation 5. Equation 4 as well as equation 5. The left hand sides are considered to be equal. See, it is n into phi means then the total flux also I can write it out as what? The total flux also I can write it out as n into phi b. If so, then I have to take this like this. Instead of phi, I can put it as phi b. So n into phi b. So here also I have to put it as n into phi b then. So the total flux available is n into phi b, which is given as L into I. So on equating the equation number 4 and equation number 5, both the left hand sides are equal. So we can equate both the right hand sides. Therefore, I can write L into I is equal to mu 0 into n square into I into capital A into L. So how you can simplify this current I? Okay, instead of capital I, I can put it as small I. If I am using capital I throughout, then I can use capital I. If I am using small I, then I can use that small I. So instead of capital I, here also I am putting it as I. So L into I is equal to mu 0 into n square into I into A into L. So on the left hand side with I and the right hand side with I will get cancelled. So the coefficient of self-inductance of a long solenoid is given by mu 0 into n square into A into L. So the coefficient of mutual induction is given by the formula L is equal to mu 0 into n square into a into L, where I can say small n as number of turns, okay, small n as number of turns per length or per unit length. For 1 meter length, the number of turns available is considered to be what? Is considered to be small n. Suppose, see, when I am considering this is solenoid. See, when I am taking this solenoid, inside this solenoid, we are having what? Inside this solenoid, we are having air medium. If some other dielectric or if some other medium is filled up, some other medium is filled inside the solenoid, filled inside the solenoid in order to increase the coefficient of self-inductance, then what we can do? See, if some other medium is filled inside the solenoid with relative permeability, with relative permeability equal to mu r, permeability as mu r, then the coefficient of self-inductance L is equal to mu 0 into mu r into n square into a into L. But we know that mu, the permeability of the medium, is equal to mu 0 into mu r. So in this equation, replacing mu 0 into mu r with mu, I can write the coefficient of self-inductance of a long solenoid is equal to L is equal to mu into n square into a into L. So this equation gives what? This equation gives the expression for the coefficient of self-induction in case of a long solenoid filled with some other medium other than that of air. This we are taking it as the coefficient of self-inductance in case of a long solenoid. Okay, let us summarize. You see, in this video we are going to get an expression for the self-inductance of a long solenoid. So for that, I am considering a long solenoid. This long solenoid usually called out as an ideal solenoid. If the length of the solenoid is large compared to its radius or diameter, then we can say that solenoid is an ideal solenoid. Here I have considered a solenoid where the length of the solenoid is L and the number of turns per unit length is small n, and area of cross section is A, and let I be the current flowing through the solenoid. See, when you are supplying the current through the solenoid, along the center or along the axis of the solenoid, a magnetic field is developed. That magnetic field developed is B, which is given by the formula mu 0 into N into I. Using Ampere's circuit law in the third lesson, you might have derived this equation. Now, so when you are calculating the magnetic field, we can calculate the magnetic flux. So we are calculating the magnetic flux linked with each turn of the coil. So the magnetic flux is given as phi B, which is linked with each turn, is given by the formula B into A into cos theta. Theta becomes 0, so cos 0 is 1. So the magnetic flux linked with a single turn is considered to be phi B, which is equal to B into A. What is B? From equation 1, we can substitute as mu 0 into N into I, multiplied it with the A. Now, let us calculate what is the total flux linked with all the N number of turns. So the total magnetic flux linked with all the n number of turns is given by N into phi B, which is again capital N into mu 0 into N into I into A. Let us take this as equation number 3. What is that capital N? Capital N is the total number of turns available for that length L. That is small n, number of turns per unit length, multiply it with L. That is capital N is equal to N into L, small n into length of the solenoid. Take this value and substitute in equation 3. We can write N into phi B is equal to mu zero into n into I into A into. Instead of capital N, I am substituting N into L. So multiply, we will be getting the total flux linked with all the N number of turns is given as mu zero into N square into I into A into L. But we have defined this coefficient of self-induction in the previous question as the total flux available N into phi B is equal to L into I. Compare this equation 4 and equation 5. Both the left hand side are equal. So we can equate both the right hand sides. While equating both the right hand sides, I can write L into I is equal to mu 0 into N square into I into A into L. On both sides, I can cancel the current I. So L equal to coefficient of self-inductance, L is equal to mu 0 into N square into A into L, where small n is the number of turns per unit length. Now, when you are considering this equation, we are having mu 0 as the permeability. That is, inside the solenoid, you are having air medium as the dielectric. Now, instead of this air medium, if you are introducing some other material or some other magnetic material in order to increase the coefficient of self-inductance, and if that medium is, the introduced medium is having a permeability called to be mu r, then we can say that coefficient of self-induction L is equal to mu 0 into mu r into N square into A into L. But the permeability of the medium mu equal to mu 0 into what? Mu 0 into mu r. So replacing this mu 0 into mu r as mu, I can write the coefficient of self-inductance is equal to mu into N square into A into L, where mu is considered to be the permeability of the medium that was being introduced inside what? That was being introduced inside the coil of wire or inside the solenoid. Hope you should have understood an important question. Maybe asked for what? Maybe asked for 3 marks. Okay, let us move on to the next question. So the next question that we are going to study is, we are going to derive an expression for the energy stored in an inductor. See, when you are considering the coil of wire or when you are considering an inductor or a solenoid, and through that solenoid, when you are supplying the electrical current, what happens? Whenever the current is established in the circuit, that inductance opposes the growth of the current in that circuit. Why? Because due to the change in current, the magnetic flux changes. Due to change in magnetic flux, the self-induced EMF is induced. That self-induced EMF always flows in a direction opposite to that of the current that is flowing. So whenever the current is established in that circuit, the inductance opposes, because the EMF that was being induced in that inductance opposes the growth of the current. So in order to establish, I have to do what? I have to do a work done. So a work has to be done in order to overcome that opposition by an external agency. That work done in order to overcome that opposition by the external agency is stored in the inductor as the potential energy that we are going to, or we can able to call it out as magnetic potential energy. That magnetic potential energy we are going to, or we are going to derive in this concept. So what I have told, say I have said that, see, whenever a current is established in an inductor or in an inductance, in an inductor, what happens? The inductance opposes the growth of the current. See, the inductance opposes what? The inductance opposes the growth of the current. Why it opposes the growth of current? Because whenever there is a change in the current flowing through the coil, an EMF is induced in the coil by itself, called to be self-induced EMF. According to Lenz's law, the self-induced EMF is acting in a direction opposite to the direction in which the current is acting or current is flowing. So in order to overcome this opposition and to establish the current, and work has to be done by an external agency. So I am saying, in order to establish the current in the circuit, or in the inductor, whatever may be in the circuit, a work has to be done by an external agency. So we can say, in order to overcome that opposition, we are doing a work. That work should be done by applying an external force or an external agency. See, that work done is stored in the inductor. That work done is stored in the inductor in the form of magnetic potential energy. For this magnetic potential energy, I have to derive an expression. Let us see how I can able to derive an expression for this. See, for this, I have to consider an inductor. That inductor that I have taken is taken to be a pure inductor and having no resistance in it. So I am assuming, or I am considering. So I am taking, let us consider a pure inductor. That is, what do you mean by this pure inductor? That is, it is not having any resistor. So pure inductor with zero resistance, or with zero resistance. An inductor with the zero resistance is called to be a pure inductor. Now, what happens? We know that. What is the induced EMF? See, we know that the induced EMF E is equal to, that is, whenever the current that is flowing through the coil is getting established or changes, then we say that E is equal to minus of L into DI divided by DT. So the EMF that was being induced in this conductor is E due to the current that is changing, EMF. Now let us take like this. Let DW be the work done. DW be the work done in moving a charge DQ. In a time of dt, that is, dq by dt is the current, or I can say dw be the work done in establishing a small amount of current di. That small amount of current di was being written as dq in a time of dt seconds against opposition. So what will be the work done? I can write like this. Let dw be the work done in establishing a small amount of current di. That was being written as in moving a charge dq in a small time dt. So I is equal to dq divided by dt. So dt seconds against opposition. What is that work done? That work done, dw, is equal to E into dq. What is this E? The work is said to be done against the EMF that was being available. So the work done is written as minus of E into dQ. The negative sign indicates that. What I can say, the negative sign indicates that the EMF is, or the work is said to be done against the direction of EMF. How I can write dQ? But dQ is considered to be I into dt, isn't it? Di is equal to dQ divided by dt. Or I can write like this, di. So on cross multiplying, I can write dQ is equal to I into dt. So whatever may be, if I am taking it as small, like no problem, instantaneous current. So this equation can be written as minus of E into, instead of dQ, I can write it out as I into dt. Now, instead of EMF, you substitute from the above equation. So dW equal to minus of E, instead of E, minus of L into di divided by dt into I into dt. You can write it out as, or I can write capital I into dt, because here I have written it as capital I. So here also I am writing it as capital I. So what will be dW then? Then dW equal to minus of minus will become plus. So L into di divided by dt into I into dt. So this dt will get cancelled, which is equal to L into I into di. L into I into di is considered to be the small work done. Let us take this as equation number one. So the small work done in establishing a small amount of current is given by the formula L into I into di. Okay. What is the total work done in establishing a current of I amperes? So we have to calculate. Therefore, total work done in establishing, total work done in establishing a current of I ampere in the coil. I ampere in the coil is, or in the solenoids. So the total work done W equal to integral of dW. So here I can write integral of L into I into di. See, which one is the variable quantity? Current. The current varies from 0 to the maximum value capital I. So how to integrate this? When I am integrating, I can write like this. That is equal to, L is a constant, so taking it out, integral of 0 to I di. So integrate this equation. What you can able to get on integrating, I can write W is equal to L into I di. When I am integrating, it is I square divided by 2 within the limit 0 to I, which is equal to, take 2 outside, I can write L divided by 2 into upper limit, that is I square minus lower limit, it is 0. So the total work done W equal to, I can write this as half into L into I square. So the total work done W equal to half into L into I square. So I can write this work done W is stored in the inductor, as what? As potential energy. What potential energy? As magnetic potential energy. How you can able to write this energy? Energy can be written as epsilon. Here the energy is considered to be magnetic potential energy. So epsilon of B is equal to, or I can say the total work done W is equal to epsilon of B, which is half into L into I square. So I can write the energy available, epsilon B equal to half into L into I square. So this is the expression for what? This is the expression for the energy stored in an inductor when the flow of electrical current is established. Okay, from this we can calculate current density, or we can able to get, not current density, energy density. how I can able to get energy density. See, the energy density can be defined as, I can say the energy density can be defined as, energy density can be defined as energy per unit volume. So defined as energy per unit volume. So how I can get the volume of the solenoid? If A is the area and length, L is the length of the solenoid, area into length will be giving you the volume. So what is this energy density? Energy density is represented as epsilon B in small letters. So I can write epsilon B divided by volume, which is epsilon B divided by volume, can be written as area of the solenoid into length of the solenoid, which is equal to, I can write this as half into, or I can write L into I square divided by what? L into I square divided by 2. That is epsilon B. By what value I have to divide it with what? I have to divide it with A into L. So I will be getting the equation as L into I square divided by what? L into I square divided by 2 into A into L. How I can write this L? See, already we have calculated the value of L as, but we know that the coefficient of self-inductance of the long solenoid is given by mu 0 into N square into A into L. This is what we have already studied in the previous question. Take this and substitute for this L. So we can say energy density epsilon B is equal to, instead of L, I can substitute mu 0 into N square into A into L into I square divided by, again you will be getting A into L. See, on simplifying, the A will get cancelled, L will get cancelled. So the answer that is available is mu 0 into N square into I square. This is considered to be the energy density. So I have left out 2 also. So here you are having 2. So here also you are having another 2. So epsilon B, that is energy density, which is defined as energy per unit volume, is given by the formula small epsilon B is equal to mu 0 into N square into I square divided by 2. See, we can simplify this term also. How you can able to simplify this? Again, let us write, we know that the magnetic field along the axis of the solenoid is given by the formula mu 0 into N into I. Since it is considered to be mu 0 into N into I, how I can write this epsilon B? That is, epsilon B is equal to, this can be written as mu 0 N I multiplied with N into I divided by 2. See, instead of this value, mu 0 into N into I, we can replace this with the capital B, which is equal to capital B into N into I divided, isn't it? This capital B into N into I divided by what? N into I divided by 2. Capital B into N into I divided by 2. Or I can simplify this in terms of another equation also. That is, mu 0 into N square into I square divided by 2 can be written as, see, this can also be written as B square divided by 2 into mu 0. Am I correct? If you want, I can able to simplify this again. See, epsilon B is equal to, we have written it like this, mu 0 into N square into I square divided by 2. Multiply and divide the numerator and denominator by mu 0. What you can get? Epsilon B, that is energy density, energy per unit volume equal to mu 0 square N square I square divided by 2. But what is B? B, we have written it as mu 0 into N into I. Here see, 2, when you am multiplying and dividing, so in denominator also you are getting mu 0. So denominator I am writing as it is, 2 mu 0. What is this value? Mu 0 n into I is b. But here we are having mu 0 square n square I square. So we are writing the energy density epsilon b is equal to b square divided by what? B square divided by 2 into mu 0. This relation, we are calling it out as the energy density, magnetic energy density, which is stored in the solenoid, or energy per unit volume stored in the solenoid. This is called to be the energy stored, or the magnetic potential energy stored in the solenoid. Okay, let us recall. You see what I have told you. We have calculated an expression for the magnetic potential energy stored in an inductor. See, for that, what explanation I have given? See, whenever you are having a current that is established in the coil of wire, then the inductance will oppose the growth of the current. Then in order to establish the current in that solenoid, by overcoming the opposition, I have to do an external work with an external energy or with an external agency. That external work done in order to overcome the opposing EMF and establishing the current, the work done is stored as the magnetic potential energy in the inductor. So let us consider the inductor of n number of turns per unit length, having the length is L and the supplied current be I. We know that due to the change in current, the EMF induced is E is equal to minus of L into di by dt. So the current that we are supplying here, I am taking it as I. Now, in order to overcome the opposition produced by this EMF for the flow of electrical current, a small work is said to be done in establishing a small amount of current di. For that, we are saying let dw be the work done in order to make a small amount of charge dq flowing for a time dt seconds against the opposition. So that work done is given by dw. Work done is given by the formula potential difference into charge moved. So the, here the potential difference is EMF. So the EMF is E. The charge mode is considered to be dq. The charge that is the work done, work is said to be done against the EMF. So we are putting a negative sign. So we can say the negative sign indicates that the work is said to be done against the EMF. So instead of dq, I can substitute. We know that di is equal to dq by dt. So dq is equal to I into dt. So I am writing the small work done dw equal to minus of E into I into dt. So dw equal to minus of, instead of E, when you are substituting, minus of L into di by dt into I into dt. So on simplifying, dt dt will get cancelled. So I am getting it as minus of I into di. This is a small work done in establishing a small amount of current called to be di. Now, in order to establish a current of I amperes in that solenoid, what I am going to do? I am going to integrate this equation so that I can able to get the total work done. So the total work done in establishing a current of I ampere in the coil is given as W is equal to integral of dW, which is equal to integral of 0 to I L into I into di. So on integrating, L is a constant, taking L out, when integrating I di, I will be getting I square by 2. By applying the limits, I can write it out as half into L into I square. This work done is stored in that inductor as magnetic potential energy. So magnetic potential energy is given by the formula epsilon B equal to half into L into I square. Similarly, so the energy can be defined as the work done stored in that the work done is stored as the magnetic potential energy in that inductor. Now, from this energy, I have to calculate the energy density. How I can write energy density? The energy density can be defined as energy per unit volume. So we know that energy density is energy divided by volume. Volume is area of the coil into length of the coil. So epsilon B is equal to, small epsilon B is equal to capital epsilon B divided by AL. Now, epsilon B is given by the formula half into L into I square divided by A into L. But in the previous question, that is in case of self-inductance in a long solenoid, we have calculated the value of L as mu 0 into N square into A into L. Substituting, we can get epsilon B equal to L is equal to mu 0 N square A into L into I square by 2 into A into L. On simplifying, I can get what is the value? I can get epsilon B, that is energy density, is equal to mu 0 into N square into I square divided by 2. But this can be written in another way. After this, you come here. See, epsilon B is, that is energy density, epsilon B is given by mu 0 into N square into I square divided by 2. But we know that B is equal to mu 0 into N into I. So what I am doing is, I am dividing and multiplying the above equation, this equation, with mu 0. So I get mu 0 square N square I square by 2 mu 0. Here, mu 0 square N square I square is B square divided by 2 mu 0. Or also I can write like this, B into N into I divided by 2. This will be used for what? This may be used for solving problems. Or I can write this as B square divided by 2 mu 0. The reason is this one. By multiplying the numerator and the denominator of the left hand side with the help of mu 0, we can get the energy density, that is energy per unit volume, magnetic energy stored in the inductor per unit volume, called to be energy density, is equal to B square divided by 2 mu 0. This is known as or expression for energy density. Hope you should have understood what I have taught in this video. Let us go with the next concept in the next video. Until then, goodbye and thank you from Ravi Shankar. Thank you.